This is the beautiful old St. Joseph's Catholic Church here in Newtown in Sydney. And you can see the Vesica Pisces vaginal-esque, female-esque doorway here, this portal way. And within here you can see the floral design, foliage as I term it, within the detail on the door. Of course you see it bursting out of the pillars also, these pillars of light, these portal ways. If we turn around this way, let's go and have a closer look at the gates up here, these red gates, where you would have Jachin and Boaz perhaps on either side, and then you've got your gates here. Now, all over the gates, we have various features. Looking up here, if we can just get the light right, you have, interestingly, you have these kind of features here, one, two, three, four. It's like the sort of four in a way around the one here, this sort of detail here, and it's all the foliage, if you will. Up on here you have the four, these sort of four aspects also. Further, if we look at the work here, within this flower you perhaps have the, in a way, a depiction of the sun also, the spirit of the sun. And these W's are perhaps refer to water, the element of water. And if we look further at the detail here, we can see that we have the surrounding pillars here, and there's nothing in the middle, there's no pillar in the middle. But if we look down here, we can see that down here we do have the depiction of a pillar in the middle, sort of foliage, if you will, within the detail here, with the four main sort of pathways coming out, if you will, earth, air, fire, and water perhaps. So you would have that's the central pillar depicted in here, going from the ground up and through, and you can see depiction of the foliage there. And then again, if we look right up in here, and I'm trying to get a shot, you can see the further depiction in here of the central pillar up there again, going through. So it's depicted in here, but sort of only sort of partial part of it. So the central pillar is in this part here, and then in this part it's not there, but you can see the top of it depicted up here, and you can see this piece right here. So just an interesting feature that no one would ever really pick up. I've learned to search for the central etheric pillar, which is often described as a leafy pillar, or there may be a flower like a rose or a lotus, etc. there. And the totality of the pillar is not necessarily shown, but there are indications of it here and there. So I'm sure that various people within occult orders would pick this stuff up. Yeah, you've just got to look around and you will see indications here and there. So we're going to have a look up here, and sure enough, we can see the flower in the center, like the rose or the lotus in the center of this monument. If we pull back from this monument, again, we can see the central pillar. It's visible up the top there, going through. So you have the four around the one with the etheric pillar running through the middle. That's not depicted here. Now, as I climb up this wall and we have a further look, we can see that there's a hole in the top, but you have the four bits there around the one, if you will. If we look down on here, you have the four little features just here. There are four of them around it. Something missing out of the top, but you also have these waves here, which perhaps refer to the sun, as in the sun well, or to water also. So I thought this was quite interesting. Here's another look at some of the features here also, reminiscent of the crown, of the Queen's crown, I would suggest here with this feature. And further features along here. Within the detail here, you can see the weirdness of the foliage and also these kind of discs coming through here. Yet another feature would perhaps be this part here, which would be the ring, perhaps. It's what I call the ring, and you can see it within the architecture of various churches, I would suggest. Also, you can see the spiraling energy, I would suggest, sort of coming out of here, these flows of etheric energy, I would suggest. Around this side of St. Joseph's Church here, you can see these old stairs here. This is quite an old church. The stairs are kind of giving away there. But we can see what I would suggest are the kind of portal ways going up here, with the mage in the center, the goddess in this case, with the crown on and the robes. And you can see the foliage below her, and you can see the grotesque, in this case, below her. Now, these would emerge, as you can see elsewhere, such as Rookwood, from the foliage. So these are depictions, I would suggest, of spirits visualized within the ritual edifice. There are further grotesques or gargoyles within and around the church. Get some of those. And you can see the cross, interestingly enough, emanating through the foliage. And if we look at the foliage, you can see that it's the weirdness of it here with the vortex depicted here, this vortex within the foliage. And from that vortex, you would have the emergence, I would suggest, of the green man, or this creature here, this grotesque, if you will, through these interdimensional portal ways. The cross up here, the four directions, the four elements, the four seasons, the portal way there, further depictions here within the windows on the rows up here, and you can see the pentagram, the four elements and the spirit, the three doorways, if you will, kind of one, two, three in there, in a way. And even within the downpiping on this church, you can see that sort of foliage aspect, that kind of flower aspect. Attention to detail. looking from an easterly direction here, just at the architecture mainly here, and it's just, we have this nice sort of tight little stairway going up here, just as an extra thing to kind of look at. Within the ironwork here, you have the cross, and within that, that's perhaps a depiction of the four in a way around the one, also in the magic circle. I've shown this place before. Up here you would have a spirit entity, I would suggest, winged, with the a glass representation of the ritual edifice up here, I would suggest, with the four outer pillars of light around the inner one, and there's a, like, you can put an orb in the center there, so the orb in the center of the magic ritual edifice, I would suggest. And there's other imagery around here that pertains to the occult, I would suggest. And the glass blower, the place here is Cydonia. And of course, that's the area on Mars where you perhaps have the face on Mars, and there is more occult imagery up here. We can also see the feminine ladies there in glass. And the glass in a way looks like water, and glass is of course a fluid substance to a certain degree. This building is very impressive with the glass fortification on the front, this sort of wave of glass, once again symbolic of water. It's like a wave of water symbolism, but it also, it's acting as a security barrier. You can see the various sort of gargoyle type creatures within the building, and serpent-like creatures as well. Obelisk here in Newtown sits within the magic circle, I would suggest. You have the entities down on the corners here, perhaps representative of spirits. And of course it's four-sided, so you have the four elements of earth, air, fire and water. So you have the boats here that would represent water, and you have the fire with the torches here, and indeed up on the top a depiction of fire. And you have the foliage right here, the leafy matter, the leaves depicted on here, representing earth perhaps. And there is perhaps a representation of wind or air in here too. You have the spiraling energies going right through this whole monument, but depicted up here. And you can see the flame on the lotus petals up here also. You have the guardians, I would suggest, the lions' faces emanating out, in this case, of this ritual edifice, kind of emerging through, if you will. the astral boats here, similar to what's depicted in Egypt. This is a war memorial, so Egypt, the actual Egypt happens to be right up here also, but this obelisk is here in Newtown in Sydney. I'm outside the central local court here in Sydney, and up here within the crest, it's interesting that there's that kind of orb in a way below the crown up here, and you can see the veil perhaps depicted within the crest here also, and the angel dovetailing, if you will, within that harp, and also I would suggest dovetailing coming out of the foliage too. You can see a depiction of that. So we have these two pillars here that lead up to the court, and you can see the energies perhaps here with the lotus leaves here, and it's a pillar of light with a spirit orb perhaps within this pillar depicted here in front of this courthouse here in Sydney. Also within these poles you can perhaps see the sun depicted here with the sun rays, the rays of the sun coming down, the sun well depicted here.
That the mind is spread out over space and over time.
Bingo.